In today's session, we will be looking at one more simple problem, how we can apply the Meson's gain formula for a given signal flow graph. Okay, one problem we will look into. Then we will see a procedure for converting any given block diagram into signal flow graph. Because as we have already seen, the some basics about what is this block diagram technique and what is the signal flow graph. We feel that signal flow graph method is easy to find the transfer function because you don't have any reduction, elaborate reduction technique is not involved here. So it is possible that if a block diagram is given to you without going for block diagram reduction using those rules, we can convert the given block diagram into signal flow graph and we can apply the Meson's gain formula. That is one procedure we will look at, and we will try to look the vice versa. If a signal flow graph is given to you, can we be able to find the block diagram for it, a reverse procedure? So we will be looking in today's session, these three things, one problem and two conversions. So this is the given problem. A signal flow graph is given to you. For this particular question, we have to apply Meson's gain formula to find the transfer function. So let us start with the procedure. Hope you remember the procedure. Let me just show you quickly. Some five steps are involved to find the transfer function applying Meson's gain formula. First step, we need to find the number of forward paths available in the given signal flow graph. Okay, so first step we will follow. Okay, how many forward paths are there? From X1 node to X2 to X3 to X4 to X5. So this is one forward path available in the given signal flow graph. X1, X2, X3, X4, X5. So first forward path, let me take that as a P1. Okay, and how we will represent these paths or gains, the loops here, when we are talking about Meson's gain formula, every aspect we will talk in terms of gains only. So when I'm telling you that there is a forward path from X1 to X5, I have to multiply the gains which come in that line, in that path. So how many gains are available? A12, A23, A34, and A45. I have to multiply all the gains. So this is your first path. Okay. Now, try to analyze the given signal flow graph. Is there any other forward path available? Forward means it should start from input, it should end at the output, and no nodes should be repeated. Okay. And you should not have any opposite direction in that. Forward path we should have. So let us see, let us try. This is first starting, obviously we should start from X1 only, one line. Can we divert from this line here? Observe, no, I cannot because it's a reverse direction. Here also I cannot go here because it's a reverse direction. Here also, no, I cannot. So again, come here. Now from this, can I divert instead of going in this way? Yes, I can move in this way because the direction is in forward, right? Forward path. Yes. So we have one more path available here. Look, what is the path available? This is the path starting from X1, then X2, then X3. Yahan tak to first path bhi same hai, right? X1 to X2, X2 to X3. From this, first path ke liye we went in this direction. For the second path, we will follow this line. So this is the second forward path. So we have started at X1, we will end at X5. So what is that second forward path? Say P2. We will denote it as P1 and P2. And what are the gains available? A12, A23. And A35. So these are the gains. You have to multiply the gains. You have to take their product. So So we have identified two paths. One is from the red color. You can see one is red color path. The other one is yellow color. So there are two forward paths available in the given signal flow graph. First step is over. Let us go to the second step. What is the second step? Find the possible single loops, individual loops. We have to find all the possible single loops. So let us see how many single loops are available. Here you can find one loop. Then you have one more loop here. Then any other? Yes, you have one more here. Three loops. Then is it possible to go in this direction? Check. No, I don't think so it is possible, because if you see the directions, ye to forward mein hai. Yahan pe agar humko back loop form karna hai, to this should be opposite. So this is not possible. So ye to possible nahi hai. 1, 2, 3. Any other loop you can find? So this is not possible. Three loops I have identified. Any other? Can anybody tell me any single loop available still which I'm missing here? Anyone wants to unmute and answer? Try at least. Aapko kahin par single loop dikh raha hai in this given question which I am missing out? So how many loops are available in this particular signal flow graph? Let me just identify. The first one is this. Okay, the first one is, then second loop, third loop. Oh, sorry, this is not possible, right? So three loops, then fourth loop from this to this. Okay, a bigger loop. So this is fourth loop, and the fifth loop. Fifth loop is starting from x2, you know, a pipe kind of a shape, to x5, coming back to x2. So totally five loops are available. Three loops with the yellow color line, one is the bigger loop with the red color, then the green color is one more. So totally five single loops are there. And again, as I told you, in the Meson's gain formula, we talk every term in terms of gains. So even when I'm talking about one loop, that loop I will represent in terms of gain only. Okay, so for first yellow color, that is, let me just erase this. So this, for first loop, what is the representation? First loop is P11. I'm taking the notation for single loops as 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. The first number 1 indicates a single loop. Agar mujhe two non-touching loops lena hai, so I will take 21, 22, 23. 2. The first number indicates two non-touching loops. So agar three non-touching loops lena hai, I should be taking P31, 32, 33. Like that. Okay. So now P11 is this loop. What is the gain? A23 multiplied by A32. So A23 multiplied by A32. Then second loop, I have taken P12 as A23. I think this is the second loop which I have taken. So second loop, and the numbering, if you just shuffle it, no issues, because at the end you are adding all together. So A23, A34, A42. That is your second single loop. Coming to the third. Third one is, let us take the smaller one, A44. So it is third loop in terms of gain. Now fourth loop, which you people identify, the bigger one. What are the values for bigger loop? A23, A34, A45 and A52. Four different gain values. You have to multiply. Then the final last one, fifth one, which you directly cannot see. You have to analyze the directions. Then you can find this loop which is hidden inside. A23, A35, A52. So I have identified single loops. So five single loops are there in the given signal flow graphs. Now, what is the next step? In the second step itself, we have to find number of single loops. Then we have to see how many two non-touching loops and how many three non-touching loops and so on. So we have identified single loops. Now let's see how many two non-touching loops are there. Okay, any loops which are non-touching? Yeah, I think this is directly visible. Ye jo hai, this one with this. These two loops are non-touching because they don't have any common node in between them. So these two are non-touching loops. Ye ek ho gaya. Any other non-touching loops you can find? Just try it. Hamare paas five single loops hain. उसमें से ये एक पैर जो है वी हैव आइडेंटिफाइड दैट दीज टू लूप्स दे आर नॉन टचिंग. बाकी सब तो ऑलमोस्ट टचिंग ही हैं. यू कैन सी ये जो फॉरवर्ड पाथ है आपका अवेलेबल, ये फॉरवर्ड पाथ को मोस्ट ऑफ द लूप्स, एवरी लूप एक्चुअली दे आर कोइंसाइडिंग. सो यू सी ट्राई टू आइडेंटिफाई हाउ मेनी नॉन टचिंग लूप्स आर देयर. Is there any other loop which is non-touching? ये तो एक हो गया non-touching loops. Say 2122 will take 823 into 832. ये जो first loop का gain है, this should be multiplied with A44. So 1, 2, 3, three numbers will be multiplied. 2, 3, 3, 2 and A44. So ये तो एक pair हो गया. Then any other pair you can see. This is one loop and the last one which we identified, this one. These two are also non-touching because they don't have any common node in between them. Okay, there is no sharing node. So these two pairs are also non-touching loops. So what are the gain values? A23, A35, A52. So in tino ko multiply karo along with A44. So four terms will come, four terms. So two non-touching loops are two. Then coming to three non-touching loops. I don't think so three non-touching loops kahin par bhi possible hai yahan pe. Kyunki even if you take two, okay, do aapko mil gaye hain, third loop kaise bhi ho, wo touch ho hi jayega. See here, yahan pe hai ya yahan pe hai. Take all the possibilities jo humne five loops identify kiye hain. Three non-touching loops is very, very, very rare. यहाँ पे तो नहीं है. यू ट्राई ऑल द पॉसिबिलिटीज. इफ यू सी ये जो लूप है, दिस एंड दिस पेयर इज नॉन टचिंग. बट इफ यू वांट थ्री नॉन टचिंग, वन मोर अगर आपको लूप लेना है तो आप ये ले सकते हो. बट यहाँ पर कॉमन शेयरिंग नोड्स आ जाएंगे. ओके, सो यू कांट हैव थ्री नॉन टचिंग लूप्स. यस, A42 and A35 can't be single non-touching. A42 and A35. Let me see. A42 and A35. Just a second. What you said is, okay, what I have understood about your question is, you are asking me A42 means this loop. Okay, this loop and A45, this loop. These two are non-touching. They cannot be because आप देख सकते हो X2 node common है. It is sharing between these two loops. So they are not non-touching. They are touching loops. Okay. I hope I have understood your question correctly. You are asking me these two loops only. You cannot take these are non-touching. Okay. Then just you can unmute and ask me the question. No problem. at A42 and A35. At A42 and at A35. A35, ये तो loop है ही नहीं, okay? You cannot take this as a loop itself. ये तो this is discarded. A42 means ये एक loop हो गया आपका. So A35 means obviously यही loop आएगा ना. So we have identified number of forward paths, number of single loops, number of two non-touching loops, number of three non-touching loops. These all data, what we have collected, this is required for us in the Mason's gain formula. So let us now solve the Mason's gain formula. What is delta? We have to find, the next step is finding the delta value. So I think, let me just show you the steps. That is better. So we have found all these single loops, two non-touching loops, three non-touching loops. After that, we should calculate a delta and then delta k. Delta 1, delta 2, delta 3. After that, directly formula. Okay. So let me first calculate what is delta. I have written the value here. Delta equals to, delta is equal to 1 minus, sorry, the value of delta is 1 minus number of single loops. कितने हैं? 5, right? P1, P2, P3, it's here. P11, P12, P13, P14 and P15. So 5, जो भी हमारे loops आए हैं, single loops, उनके जो gain products हैं, right hand side, इसको आपको add करना है, according to the formula. Sum of gains of single loops, 5, okay? प्लस अल्टरनेटिव प्लस माइनस साइन आएगा, माइनस के बाद प्लस आएगा. नेक्स्ट नंबर ऑफ टू नॉन टचिंग लूप्स कितने हैं? वी हैव आइडेंटिफाइड टू, P21 एंड P22. सो इन दोनों को भी ऐड करना है, सम ऑफ, ओके, अकॉर्डिंग टू द फॉर्मूला. नेक्स्ट अल्टरनेटिव नेगेटिव आएगा. नेक्स्ट फॉर्मूला में क्या होगा? सम ऑफ द पॉसिबल कॉम्बिनेशंस ऑफ थ्री नॉन टचिंग लूप्स. बट हमारे जो गिवन सिग्नल फ्लो ग्राफ है उसमें आपको थ्री नॉन टचिंग लूप्स नहीं मिले, सो इट इज जीरो. सो दैट्स व्हाई आई हैव नॉट रिटन द नेक्स्ट टर्म इन द फॉर्मूला. सो दिस इज डेल्टा. देन वी शुड गो फॉर कैलकुलेशन ऑफ डेल्टा के. सो कितने डेल्टा के आएंगे? द नंबर ऑफ फॉरवर्ड पाथ्स इज इक्वल टू, नाउ जितने आपके फॉरवर्ड पाथ्स रहेंगे उतने डेल्टा वैल्यूज आपको कैलकुलेट करने पड़ेंगे, डेल्टा के. ओके, हियर द फॉरवर्ड पाथ्स आर 2, सो आई हैव टू फाइंड डेल्टा 1 एंड डेल्टा 2. इफ द फॉरवर्ड पाथ इज ओनली 1, आई हैव टू फाइंड ओनली डेल्टा 1. दैट्स व्हाट वी डिड इन द प्रीवियस प्रॉब्लम. ओके, बिकॉज इन द प्रीवियस प्रॉब्लम देयर वाज ओनली 1 फॉरवर्ड पाथ वी आइडेंटिफाई, बिकॉज ऑफ व्हिच वी कैलकुलेटेड ओनली डेल्टा 1. ओके, now in the current problem we have identified two forward paths, because of that we have to calculate two delta values. So what is delta 1 is equal to? Delta 1 is 1 minus, let me show you the formula, that would be better. Yeah, so delta 1 is for first forward path 1 minus sum of single loops that are not touching the forward path 1. मैं ये जो डेल्टा लिख रही हूं, the formula, it is applicable to first forward path. So I have to check those single loops which are not touching that forward path. Then alternative minus plus minus plus. Sum of those, gain values of those two non-touching loops. Again, टू नॉन टचिंग लूप्स ऐसे होने चाहिए जो आपका जो फॉरवर्ड पाथ है, फर्स्ट फॉरवर्ड पाथ, उसको टच नहीं होने चाहिए. ओके, सच लूप यू हैव टू फाइंड. देन अल्टरनेटिव नेगेटिव, नेगेटिव साइन एंड सो ऑन. टू नॉन टचिंग, देन थ्री नॉन टचिंग, फोर नॉन टचिंग, लाइक दैट इट विल कंटिन्यू. सो अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस फॉर्मूला इट विल बी 1 माइनस, ओके, 1 माइनस, आई हैव रिटन हियर 0. व्हाट इज 0 इंडिकेटिंग? I have not found any loop which is not touching the forward path. Okay, let me analyze this, whether this is correct or not. Aapka first forward path ye hai. Okay, this is your first forward path. we have identified the loops. You check, this is your first loop. This is a touching the line, the forward path. This is your one more loop. It is also touching the forward path. This third loop, it is also touching the forward path, first forward path. Then any other? ये तो अब possible नहीं है. The bigger loop. This one. Even this is also touching here. X2, X3 and X5. Yes, it is touching the forward path. And the last possibility, this. This is also touching at X2 and X3. So if you see, जितने हमारे single loops हैं, five single loops, all are touching that forward path. That's why I have taken it zero. And there is no question of further moving, क्योंकि single ही नहीं है, तो two loops कैसे नहीं touch नहीं होते हैं? वो तो possible ही नहीं है. So the one minus zero. Now coming to delta 2, क्योंकि two forward paths are available. So delta 1 I have calculated. Similarly, let me say what is delta 2 equals to. Delta 2 is equal to 1 minus. Again, I have to look for such single loop which is not touching that forward path. So pehle, let me just draw the forward path. Yes, this is my forward path. Second forward path which I have identified. Okay, now try to identify such loop. Aapke paas five single loops hain. Is there any one loop in that which is not touching this? Consider this. Ye to touch ho raha hai yahan pe. Consider this loop. It is also touching here in these two positions. Then third loop. It is also touching here. Then the bigger loop, it is also touching here. So any other remaining which is not touching the this forward path, ek loop bacha hai. This is your forward path. See, this is that loop. It is not touching this forward path. So I can take this. So I have taken that 1 minus A44. Okay. Then next in the formula, it is plus. I have to identify such two non-touching loops जो इस path को touch ना हो. वो तो possibility बहुत कम है. Let's see. ये आपका forward path available है. Two non-touching loops हमने कौन से identify किए हैं? ये वाला तो एक है. This pair. Yes. This is one pair. Whether they are not touching the forward path, ये तो touch नहीं हो रहा है. But what about this loop? It is touching. So एक possibility तो नहीं है. Now, coming to the second possibility. What is the second pair of two non-touching loops? Sorry. Ye aapka forward path hai. Ye ek hai. Second pair I'm talking about. This is your second pair. This one and this one. So again, if you see, yahan par bhi ye to touch nahi ho raha hai. Okay? It's very clear. But look at this loop. यहाँ पर वो टच हो रहा है, ओके? क्योंकि ये आपका फॉरवर्ड पाथ है, इस फॉरवर्ड पाथ में, इफ यू ऑब्जर्व दैट शेप, दिस शेप, ये जो लूप है आपका, यहाँ पर टच हो रहा है वो फॉरवर्ड पाथ के लिए, सो इवन दिस इज़ आल्सो डिस्कार्डेड, आपके पास सिर्फ दो ही ऐसे लूप्स अवेलेबल हैं, नॉन टचिंग लूप्स, उसमें से दोनों ही पॉसिबिलिटीज वी कैन डिस्कार्ड, सो फर्दर वी कैन नॉट कंटिन्यू द फॉर्मूला. That's it. 1 minus A44 plus 0 minus 0 and so on. Because yahan par hi stop ho gaya hai. So we delta 1 and delta 2. No need to go for delta 3 kyunki humare paas forward paths sirf 2 available hain. So delta 1 and delta 2. Now we can directly take the formula. Transfer function T is 1 by delta summation Pk into delta k. Ma'am, please repeat how to take delta 2. Okay, fine. Let me take different colors, then you'll understand. Okay. For this to understand, you first see how many two non-touching loops are there. How many two non-touching loops are there? First, you see the formula. The formula says, if you want to find a delta value, you have to take 1 minus sum of single loops which are not touching that forward path. Then pehle to single loops lenge formula mein, then we'll go for two non touching loops and then three non touching loops and then four non touching loops and so on. ye to aapka formula ho gaya. So first we will see कितने सिंगल लूप्स अवेलेबल हैं जो उस फॉरवर्ड पाथ को टच नहीं करते हैं. ओके, सो नाउ यू वांट फॉर डेल्टा टू. सो उसके लिए व्हाट आई विल डू, जो आपका सेकेंड फॉरवर्ड पाथ आइडेंटिफाइड है, आई विल ड्रॉ दैट. दिस इज योर सेकेंड फॉरवर्ड पाथ. ओके, नाउ वी विल सी हाउ मेनी सिंगल लूप्स आर देयर विच आर नॉट टचिंग दिस लाइन. ओके, लाइन इंडिकेट्स वो नोड्स भी आ जाएंगे. ओके, फर्स्ट लेट मी टेक दिस सिंगल लूप येलो कलर. ओके, इज इट टचिंग दिस फॉरवर्ड पाथ? यस, इट इज टचिंग. यहाँ पे एक्स टू एंड एक्स थ्री ये कॉमन ब्रांच है ना दोनों के लिए, तो इट इज टचिंग द फॉरवर्ड पाथ. नाउ टेक द नेक्स्ट लूप, ये ले लो सेकेंड लूप, सिंगल लूप. Whether this is touching your path, orange color line को touch हो रहा है, yes, you can see X2 and X3 common node है दोनों के लिए, ये branch को pass होके ही ये loop बनेगा, so even that is discarded. Then the bigger loop, this one, the bigger loop you can see. Whether this is not touching this orange line, again, X2 and X3 point पे वो क्रॉस हो रहा है, after that it is continuing, यहाँ पर ये divert हुआ है, so X2 and X3 path is common. Even this is also discarded. Coming to the next line, let me take this green color, the fourth loop. This is not touching the orange line. Check, orange color X1, X2, X3 से हो गए, X5 को जा रहा है, but X4 का जो लूप है, X4 to X4 सेल्फ लूप, इट इज नॉट एट ऑल टचिंग द ऑरेंज लाइन, सो दिस आई कैन कंसिडर. ओके, नाउ कितने हो गए लूप्स? वन टू थ्री फोर लूप्स हो गए. फिफ्थ लूप, स्टिल वन मोर लूप इज रिमेनिंग बिकॉज वी हैव आइडेंटिफाइड फाइव लूप्स. दिस इज वन मोर लूप, द ब्लू कलर विच आई एम ड्रॉइंग, दिस इज वन मोर लूप. सी वेदर दिस ब्लू कलर इज टचिंग इन द ऑरेंज लाइन एनीवेयर. Yes, it is touching. Where all? X2 से X3 common branch है. From X2, yes, sorry, X3 से X5 को भी वो orange line पे वो blue line pass हो रहा है. So it is touching that forward path. When I'm drawing, when I'm finding a delta k value, either delta 1 or delta 2, delta 1 के लिए अगर हम calculate कर रहे हैं, तो first forward path को touch हो रहा है, नहीं हो रहा है देखना है. अगर डेल्टा टू कैलकुलेट कर रहे हैं, तो सेकेंड फॉरवर्ड पाथ को टच हो रहा है नहीं हो रहा है, वी हैव टू चेक. ओके, सो फॉरवर्ड पाथ जितने हैं उतने डेल्टा वैल्यूज कैलकुलेट करने हैं. सो इफ यू सी ओवरऑल, ये जो फाइव लूप्स हैं हमारे, उसमें से सिर्फ एक जो ग्रीन लूप है, वो एक ही ऑरेंज लाइन को टच नहीं हो रहा है. बाकी जो फोर लूप्स, सिंगल लूप्स अवेलेबल हैं, वो ऑरेंज लाइन को पास होके दे आर फॉर्मिंग द लूप्स. So you cannot consider those four. Only green color you have to consider. Hope you understood this. That's why I have taken it as single A44 only. आगे क्या होगा formula में? Sum of the gain values of two non-touching loops. जो आपके ये जो orange color forward path है, इसको touch नहीं हो रहा है. वो तो possibility है ही नहीं. क्योंकि पांच में से चार लूप्स ऐसे हैं जो ऑरेंज लाइन को टच हो रहे हैं, तो टू नॉन टचिंग लूप्स का तो इट्स नॉट एट ऑल पॉसिबल. यस, ओके, सो फाइनली आई हैव टू फाइंड द ट्रांसफर फंक्शन टी विच इज वन बाय डेल्टा समेशन टी के इनटू डेल्टा के. समेशन यू एक्सपांडेड, हमारे पास दो फॉरवर्ड पाथ्स अवेलेबल हैं, सो एक्सपांड द सम, इट विल बी पी वन डेल्टा वन. Substitute k as one and k as two. You get forward path one and forward path two. P one delta one, P two delta two. Summation है, you have to add. Okay? So जितने forward paths होंगे, उतने ये terms आएंगे आपको. This is the formula. So simply I have substituted the formula. What is a P one? P one is this into delta one. So delta one calculated, you can see what is the value, one. So this into one. प्लस P2, द सेकेंड फॉरवर्ड पाथ, ये कहां से आया है? Here I have already done. See, P1 and P2, I have taken directly from them. So P2 into delta 2. Delta 2 just now we have calculated 1 minus A44. ये आपका ये जो numerator है वो हो गया. यहाँ पे you can see it is 1 by delta. So 1 divided by what all delta we have calculated, write that. What is delta? It is here. 1 minus sum of gains of single loops, sum of gains of two non-touching loops, and so on. So this is the transfer function of the given signal flow graph. Hope you understood this problem. This problem was given as a homework for you. Hope you understood this.